like a fight between two villains. Terrible Terry Norris tangles with bad boy David Gonzalez for the WBC Super Welterweight title. It'll be Norris's first defense in his third reign as champion. Right now, let's go back to Jim Gray.
Okay, thank you very much, Bruce. I'm now joined by Mark Ratner. He is the executive director of the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Mark, November 4th, there has been a conflict that has gone on back and forth with two fights being scheduled here in Nevada. Without getting into that controversy, what will the Nevada State Athletic Commission do in the future so as to see that this doesn't happen?
We're going to formulate a policy after the November 4th fight. We'll invite all the promoters, the major pay-per-views, and any interested parties to try to come to a exact way of forestalling this in the future.
Do you feel as though you'll be successful in being able to prevent something like this?
Well, hopefully saner minds will prevail. The business climate being what it is, it doesn't make any sense to financially hurt each other or the state.
Mark, the last time we saw you, there was some controversy when Vinny Vecchione ran in the ring and stopped Peter McNeely in that fight. What will you do now in the future? You just had a board meeting. What will you guys do so as to prevent something like that from occurring, a trainer running into the ring?
We're going to have a new policy to stop the trainer from coming in the ring. If he does jump in the ring, first of all, our inspector in the corner will bodily grab him from doing that. If he does get in the ring, the referee has been instructed to calmly call time and escort him out of the ring, and the fight will continue.
Yet if a trainer really wants to stop a fighter from fighting, what can you do? I mean, if a guy feels that his guy's in danger.
We feel we have the best referees, or as good as referees as anybody in the world, and we will stand by their decision. They're the closest to the fighters in the ring, and I believe they can stop the fight at the right time.
No controversy yet tonight, Mark. Thanks for joining us. Let's go back upstairs to Jim Hill.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Now, before our main event, we have a world title bout in the super welterweight division. The fight features defending WBC title holder Terry Norris. Now, this is Norris's third reign as champion. You see, an upset loss and two bizarre disqualifications have cost him his title in the past. And now, he hopes to put his misfortune in the past and reclaim his position among boxing's elite. Once regarded as one of the most talented fighters in the world, Norris's skills have recently been overshadowed by his questionable ring judgment. The newly recrowned champion is known as Terrible Terry, and I'm sure he's hoping that from now on, he'll be known by his nickname for the right reasons. Coming up next, Terry Norris returns to the ring as champion to defend the WBC Super Welterweight Championship against David Gonzalez. Back down to ringside, once again, here's Bruce Beck. Bruce.
All right, thank you, Jim. There was a time when Terry Norris was considered pound for pound the best around. If not the best, certainly one of them. Starting with his victory over John the Beast Mugabe for the WBC Super Middleweight title, there was a 3.5-year period from March 1990 to December of 1993 when Terry Norris ruled the division. And his victories came against a virtual who's who in boxing: Sugar Ray Leonard, Donald Curry, Meldrick Taylor, and Maurice Blocker. All of these big-name fighters fell under the Norris wrath. Well, it all began to unravel when he was stopped in the fourth round by Simon Brown in December of 1993. Norris subsequently regained the crown from Brown, but then came one of the most bizarre trilogies in boxing history, a three-fight series with unheralded Luis Santana. The first two fights ended in disqualification. Both times Norris threw an illegal punch. Both times Santana left the arena on a stretcher. Both times Santana was declared the winner. The third and last time the two fighters met, just 26 days ago, Norris recaptured his title with a clean second round TKO. But even with the belt back around his waist, the damage has already been done to his image in and out of the ring. Ferdy, once again, how would you describe the events surrounding Terry Norris over the last 16, 18 months?
Chaotic is the word that comes to mind. A series of events which made more chaotic because of his apparent uncontrollable rage when he gets someone in trouble. Now, here's a guy that's the most peaceful, wonderful family man you ever met outside the ring. Inside the ring, something clicks and he goes crazy at that moment when he shouldn't. Now, he's never had that problem before. Couple that with a highly questionable chin. Simon Brown knocked him out. This Australian Waters had him in trouble. Everybody had him in trouble. All of a sudden, a guy who had a rock chin and was fighting great began to come apart every time he gets hit real hard. We're going to see tonight whether that chin is still made out of glass or whether he's getting some more strength to it and whether his character has changed so he can control the wrath that's so uncharacteristic of him, but which cost him all of the opinion of the boxing world. He's back down to point A. He's got to come all the way back up to where he was. It's a long road.
Well, following along those lines, do you think he blew his opportunity to become a true superstar in the sport?
Absolutely. I mean, that's like running into a stone wall. You don't overcome that, all that chaos that he created, and then step right back into being the top guy. He has got to fight hard and fight often and have impressive victories to even start to come back up to where he was. He was considered, pound by pound, not by me, but other people, the best fighting then. He won't get that again.
Well, what about tonight? Must Norris win impressively against David Gonzalez to have any chance of once again becoming part of the sports elite?
Oh, yeah. If he doesn't win tonight, and he doesn't win and look good doing it, he's just going to be another guy. He's just another good, talented fighter fighting, but not anything in the possible class of a superstar that he once was.
All right, well, speaking of David Gonzalez, the opponent tonight for Terry Norris, here he comes, and this will be his first championship fight in his 10-year career, but it's not because of a lack of effort. He has 40 wins in 45 fights, once held the NABF welterweight title, but has been subjected to fighting the likes of Skipper Kelp, Anthony Jones, Cassius Clay Horn. He's ranked number 14 by the WBC, number 12 by the WBA in the welterweight division. He's won five in a row, at least he had won five in a row before his last fight, a six-round decision in April to Daryl Lattimore.
Championship of the world, finally gonna get it, finally gonna get it. 10 years of it.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Hey, my mother's fight you.
Okay, slow, slow, slow!
En una estrella que está.
I'll tell you, David Gonzalez looks very relaxed. He says he's been waiting for this shot since he began boxing. And he says, I hope Terry Norris knows what he's getting himself into. When he's in the ring with me, I'm going to come out and give him everything I have. And now the champion, Terry Norris, the three-time title holder of the WBC 154-pound belt. He made 10 title defenses in his first two reigns as champion. This will be the first defense of his third reign as super welterweight kingpin. Norris, now 28 years of age, boasts a record of 39-6 with 24 KOs. He is 13-4 in 17 championship fights to this point.
Mr. Bombastic! What you want is a bombastic, romantic, fantastic lover.
She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic. Put me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic. Call me fantastic, touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Smooth, just like a silk. Soft and cuddly, you me up like a quilt. I'm a lyrical lover, now take me in the guilt. With my sexual physique, you know me well, Bill.
Well, kind of a mixed review from the crowd. Terrible Terry Norris making his way to the ring, albeit with some whistles and hoots. Right now for the statistical breakdown, as we check out the tail of the tape, Norris weighed in at 151, Gonzalez at 152. Norris 1 year older than Gonzalez. He's 1/2 inch taller, his reach 1/2 inch less. WBC rules are governing tonight's fight, 10-point must scoring system. Three judges score, no standing eight, no three knockdown rule. Only the ref can stop the fight. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the final round. If there's an accidental foul before the start of the fourth, the fight will be ruled a no decision. If it happens after the start of the fourth, they go to the scorecards. And so at the Mirage in Las Vegas, where a fire erupting volcano explodes every half an hour outside the hotel, we are set for an explosion in the Grand Ballroom for the introduction of the fighters, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Well, fans, we welcome you to our next championship bout coming your way, brought to you by Don King Productions and King Vision, along with Showtime, Event Television, Corona Beer, and The Mirage. At this time, we present the WBC Super Welterweight Championship, sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, the President, Jose Suleiman, Supervisor, Gabriel Peña Garicano, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission. The chairman is Dr. James Nave. And our judges at ringside scoring this bout, we have Angel Luis Guzman, Herbert Min, and Jerry Roth. Presenting to you our referee in charge, working in this his 117th world title bout, introducing Richard Steele. All right, fans, here we go with the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World, scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you first the challenger on my right, fighting out of the blue corner. He is wearing black trunks with gold trim and fighting out of Houston, Texas. He weighed in at 152 pounds with a record of 40 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw. He has 23 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is tonight's challenger making his first attempt at a world title, introducing Bad Boy David Gonzalez. And his opponent across the ring, ladies and gentlemen, is the defending world champion on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red and white trunks, representing the First Fighters Squadron in Campo, California, by way of Lubbock, Texas. He weighed in at a trim and ready 151 pounds. His record includes 39 wins, 6 losses, with 24 wins coming by way of knockout. And here is the three-time WBC Super Welterweight Champion of the World, introducing Terrible Terry Norris. And once again, here's our referee in charge, Richard Steele, now to give instructions.
Okay, I gave both of you guys instructions in the dressing room. I'm cautioning again, obey my commands at all times. In case there's a knockdown, go to the neutral corner. Stay there till I tell you to come out. Shake hands, good luck.
So we are set to go for the WBC Super Welterweight title. There is David Gonzalez finally getting an opportunity at a belt. And his opponent, Terry Norris, first title defense, but this is third reign. And as I mentioned, the lukewarm reception. Ferdy must go back to the concept that many of the fans feel he is a dirty fighter after several incidents involving Santana.
It wasn't just Santana. He's been in several instances where he hits a guy after he's down. He got by with it in other fights. It was only that Santana reacted in such a violent way. Violent, meaning he was unconscious for a long while.
Norris said a lot of that labeling is blown out of proportion.
Well, there's nothing to lose on the part of David Gonzalez. He's come out winging, but he got just hit real hard just then by Terry Norris.
Norris lands another right hand, a combination of Gonzalez in trouble here in the first round.
It's going to be interesting to see how Norris handles it when he goes down, if he can restrain himself from hitting on the way down.
Good combination by Norris. That right hand has punctuated the action thus far.
Gonzalez looks stunned and surprised. He's like, uh-oh.
Norris says he's sharp. His last fight was just 26 days ago.
Punch it out.
Gonzalez in activity 138 days.
Now, Terry's as sharp as I've seen him in the first round since I've been watching him fight. I watched him since he's a youngster. Boy, he's come out here to tear off Gonzalez's head.
Come on, don't work. Don't hold it.
Another right hand. That one didn't get through as well as the others.
I'll tell you what he's doing that is a little dangerous. He's extending himself way out to land his punch. If he gets hit in a counter punch with that glass chin, he's liable to go down. So Terry is going without any kind of control or defense here.
Don't hold him. Don't hold him.
Terry winging that right uppercut. Richard Steele separating the fighters.
Gonzalez taking a beating here. He's taking a belting.
Oh, down goes Gonzalez. It was a right hand by Norris. He gets up quickly, gets the mandatory eight count.
Give me a glove.
Norris still has a minute to try to finish him off.
Plenty of time. Plenty of time. If Terry takes his time and attacks, this guy is gone.
Norris is winging that right hand. Gonzalez looks dazed. Now he throws a jab. There is no three knockdown rule in this WBC title fight.
Well, Terry has controlled that rage pretty good. He has not lost his head. He hasn't gone in there winging. He's just going back to what got the knockdown. Intelligent fighting, taking that right hand and landing it at long range.
Left hook and a double up on the left by Terry Norris.
Hunting it out.
Gonzalez is trying to get out of this first round. He's only got 10 seconds left. Norris lands another bomb. Norris with another right hand. Good combination. A tremendous first round for Terry Norris.
You're giving it to him, baby. You're giving it to him, son. You got to back him up, brother. You're not backing him up, okay? You got to get the shit business. You got to get the shit business. Got a little cut over here, Bill. Got a big cut. Cut over here, Bill.
David, John, back it up and stand right in front of him.
Okay. All right, what do we do?
I want you to...
You got to bend them fucking...
Let's take a look at that knockdown that Terry Norris, with surprising ease, scored. I mean, it was almost... See that right hand? Perfect right hand. Now, he went down with such a resounding thud that Norris didn't hang around for one of those after the fall blows. But watch the right hand. Right there. Oh, wow. He goes down. And you see, there was no way to punch him unless you punch him in the butt there, because he was just not around to get punched. Terry looked very, very good controlling himself. He looked so far A-plus on the first round.
Cutman Bill Folliard, at the advice of trainer Willie Boyd, did some quick work in the corner to try to close up a cut on Gonzalez's face. Gonzalez comes out winging a right hand.
He better do something. You better do something to discombobulate Terry Norris, because Terry is fighting in his own time and with his own rhythm, just the way he wants to.
Norris backs up his opponent again. This time a good move off the ropes by Gonzalez.
Boy, I haven't seen Terry this sharp in a long time.
You're holding.
Well, the last Santana fight against David Gonzalez, he had a TKO.
It wasn't the same guy. Terry Norris was too cautious with Santana. He was just trying to sweet talk his way into a knockout. Here, he is back to being all out. I mean, he was so scared of doing something with Santana, he didn't look like this. This is the old Terry Norris.
Right hands, left and right. Pardon the pun. To the body goes Gonzalez. But Norris just ties him up. And Norris is thinking about one thing, that big right hand on the face of Gonzalez. Another right. Good short left hook by Terry.
Combinations, always combinations from Terry Norris. That right hand finding its mark.
Come on, Worker, get out.
And now he goes to the body. Another element.
Gonzalez goes to the body three or four times now. With Terry on the ropes, but a good right hand by Terry. He holds on. Doesn't look like he's hurt, but he did hold on.
Norris trying to measure his opponent.
Coming in with uppercuts right between his gloves.
The jab set up the right hand that time nicely.
That 1-2 is working perfectly. Now if he can only make it 1-2-3 with a left hook behind the right hand, he could get himself a knockout. There's the jab, and then the right hand follows. Right hand, beautiful.
Nice uppercut by Norris, and an overhand right.
He is pummeling, working over Gonzalez. He comes back with a desperation punch, but he's not doing anything.
Norris goes down. It was a slip. Gonzalez was on top of him. Richard Steele quick to point it out. He was just trying to hang on.
It's funny that the Mexican public here is so wants him to win so much, he thought it was a knockdown. It wasn't. It was not a knockdown.
Another good combination by Norris. That time he doubled up on the jab and landed the right. 30 seconds left in the second round.
Gonzalez fighting like a man is standing under a mountain waiting for the avalanche to crush him down.
Norris still looking, still busy.
And still scoring. Big, big points here. Each one of these rounds definitely for Norris.
And he finishes the round the way he started, with action. Let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Bruce. I'm with John Horn, the co-manager of Mike Tyson, along with Rory Holloway. John, Mike's in training now for Buster Mathis back in Ohio. How's he doing?
Mike is doing great. He's back there in training with Rory right now in Ohio. He really wanted to be here tonight, but he's totally committed to his training for his next fight right now.
Look sharp?
Mike is very sharp. As you know, you've seen him last fight. Though it didn't last long, you've seen the quality in his performance, and he's looking forward to getting back in there again, and we're very happy about fighting November 4.
You've reviewed the film with him. How does he feel he did, and is there room for improvement, and will we see more of the old guy as he fights more?
Oh, there's always room for improvement. That's what keeps Mike going so much. But Mike will be back November 4th, and he will be better, and he's been training to make himself better, and that's all his our whole camp is about. So that's why he's there right now instead of being here. He's committed to his training.
John, good to see you. We look forward to November 4th.
Thank you. Bruce?
All right, thank you very much, Jim. Terry Norris has dominated the first two rounds, had the knockdown in the first, and pretty much had things go his own way in the second. Good crisp jab by Norris. You can see the sweat just flying off the face of Gonzalez.
Good defense. Good defense right there by Terry Norris. When he wants to, he can be a good defensive fighter. His thing is that he's so offensive-minded, he doesn't pay attention to blocking punches once he gets going.
Norris holding with his left, hitting with his right. Looks like a hungry Terry Norris in there, Ferdy.
Oh, he is very hungry. He is so determined to get his place back. He's got peace of mind also. He's over that chaotic series of episodes, and he's right back on track.
A right hand landed by Gonzalez. Second time he got Norris up against the rope. Gonzalez grabs that head and just drags him back to the middle of the ring.
Yeah, he's got to make this tough. He's got to make it rough. He's got to get Terry out of that rhythm. Terry's fighting his own fight. He doesn't care what the other guy's doing.
Good combination again by Norris.
See the way he's bouncing around? That's the kind of motion that, now you see that? That's one of the reverse things. If Terry had been here and the guy'd be halfway down, he'd keep on punching, you know?
Ferdy, what about the concept of fouling, the fact that Norris has committed so many over the years? Will fighters maybe take advantage of it now, worrying that he won't keep
I don't think when you're up against a windmill like that, you're not worried about those finite little points. You're trying to fight for survival. I think, if anything, it's Norris that has to worry about fouling, and he has to hold himself back a little bit. He doesn't still go out 100%, although he looks like he's close to it here.
Can an opponent take advantage of it or not?
No, I don't think so. Keep him up. Fighting is too fast and too hard to think about fine little points like that. Expect to the other guy not to follow you in. You get killed while you're expecting other guys to do what you think.
Gonzalez getting busier.
Hard to get out.
Norris landing a right hand.
Ooh,
good left hook.
You see that series?
Crisp, and there's a right to follow it up.
You see that series? That was just beautiful vintage Terry Norris.
Fighting off the ropes and landing a right hand is Norris. Gonzalez takes a body blow, but Norris still in command, dictating the pace and landing again, right hand.
Bouncing on those legs, he's got good legs as Terry Norris. Anything that Gonzalez throws gets a roar from the crowd. This is a purely Mexican audience, it's Independence Day.
Gonzalez came in that time and ate a left.
Hunting it out. Great, step back, step back.
And the third round comes to a close. Very good action. The dressing room of Julio Cesar Chavez, the WBC super lightweight champion, getting set for his bout tonight against undefeated David Kamau, 26-0. It's been a strange week for Chavez. He's not sure what he wants to accomplish right now. And he has been complaining about a bit of a soreness here, a soreness there, Ferdy.
I'm telling you, I've been doing his fights since 1986 when I was with NBC, and he's always complained of something. I don't know. He's got the Hypochondriac Award in boxing all time.
Well, here at the Mirage, it has been Terry Norris dominating the action against David Gonzalez. Has one knockdown. That was scored in the first as we get set for the fourth round
of what may be called a one-sided fight so far. Gonzalez is trying to get something in there, hoping that that glass chin, if it's still in effect of Terry Norris, will somehow be reached by him and change the course of this fight. But all he's doing is taking a one-way beating right now.
Textbook jab by Norris.
Keep him up.
And now it's Gonzalez lunging. As referee Richard Steele tells Gonzalez to keep his punches up.
And his head out of Terry Norris' face. He puts his head in there pretty good.
Gonzalez scored there with an uppercut.
He's trying to get rough. He's trying to rough up Terry Norris, get him out of his rhythm, get him into a fight. And whether Terry responds or not is the difference between a champion and not a champion.
Swift combination by Norris.
Don't hold it.
Pretty much textbook, Ferdy.
Yep.
Jab and right hand. And the crowd again roaring when Gonzalez lands.
That's a windmill right hand. Didn't have much on it, but boy, he landed.
It's one punch against six or seven.
Yeah. Yeah, he
comes
back.
Terry comes back. Don't push.
Now Norris gets a little bit tough with Gonzalez.
This is the only sport you say, don't push, but it's all right to punch him silly. You know, it's kind of the opposite of every other sport.
Gonzalez with a crisp right to the head.
Again, the bouncing on the part of Terry Norris. Look at his leg, man. He's got like springs in there. This guy's trained.
Another 1-2.
Look at him. Bouncing along, looking like he's having a good time.
He was a great athlete as a youngster. It was once offered a baseball scholarship to Baylor University. It was only a fight on the ball field, on the diamond, that made him switch over. And now Richard Steele says, get him up, Gonzalez.
Break.
And Terry Norris now, another slip. Steele quickly stepping in. Only one knockdown of the fight. Norris knocking down Gonzalez in the first. Oh, what a jam that was. Right on the button. And now Norris doubles up with the jab and lands the straight right.
Well, back in Houston, Viscusi, this guy's manager, Lou Viscusi, his father, manager Willie Pep, Joe Brown, Bob Foster, I mean, great titles, must be dying because this guy is not putting on any kind of a performance, and Terry Norris is beating him systematically down to a knockout.
Two chopping body blows by Gonzalez, and both scored nicely.
Watch your back, watch your hold.
Final seconds of the fourth round.
You got him all frustrated, okay? Just keep boxing. Keep boxing. Don't get into his fight. All right? Come on, champ.
Just keep working. Just
keep working. Keep working. Keep working. Okay? Keep working with the jab.
No, just keep working. Lock his chin.
Don't give him no shots, okay?
Get down and get your arm. Get slick.
Get sharp.
Okay. You win.
You win. You win every round. What do you want to say?
Miss more.
Rounds. David, you want this championship, David?
Don't wait on it.
You stay busy, David. You stay busy, champ.
We're
hey, come on. Four.
Did he just ask who's winning, Ferdy?
Yeah. He asked what round it was also.
This is round five, and it's Norris who is winning.
Yeah. This depressing thing is when it's only round five, you want to lie to him and say, no, it's only a few more rounds left. But you got to tell him it's all, round five of a 12-rounder if he survives.
12-round bout for the WBC super welterweight title. Terry Norris in the red and white trunks defending the belt against David Gonzalez.
Ooh, nice right hand.
Gonzalez goes down. Will Gonzalez get up?
Nine.
The count is nine, he's
you
up.
Okay? Come on.
Second knockdown in the fight. Here comes Norris looking to finish it. Trying to unload that right hand.
But Gonzalez still trying to land that right overhand right that might change it. Can't do it.
Norris setting him up with the jab. Trying to be smart.
Norris not in a hurry, boy. He's learned his lesson. He isn't swarming in there. He's got this guy hurt bad, and he's not swarming. He's just waiting to surgically take this guy apart, one punch at a time.
Got him in the corner now. Gonzalez really weakened. Not much in his legs right now.
But he's fighting back, Bruce. He's fighting back. You got to give him credit. I mean, he's hoping for that one little gift, that one little punch in the jaw that will get Terry in trouble.
Gonzalez continues to show his mettle. Midway through this fifth round, there's a right hand by Norris as Gonzalez came in.
Yeah, that's a mark of an old, exclusive fighter. They just won't give up. They keep fighting. Now he's in trouble now.
I don't know how Gonzalez stayed up that time off that right hand.
He's taking a beating now. This
punch
is a
way out. Punch your way out. Come on, don't hold.
Inside a minute in the fifth round. Ooh, a crunching body blow by Norris. He dug the left hand to the body.
That sounded like he hit a bass drum that time. That was hard.
Don't hold him. Don't hold him.
Nothing on the punches of Gonzalez, but he is throwing.
And he is still standing.
Yeah, and he's got Terry Norris up against the ropes, not the other way around.
Work your way out, work your way out, work your way out.
Norris back with the 1-2.
Every time Terry Norris throws that right hand, Gonzalez is ducking his head down, and if Terry can turn up an uppercut after that, it'll be curtains. That's why the right hand is missing.
Well, it looks like Gonzalez trying to weather the storm here in the fifth round. He's only got a couple of seconds to go, and he gets through it somehow. Great medal.
Doing good. Wait too long, baby. You're letting this guy get to you.
Listen to me. Hey. You're waiting too much on me. You're waiting too much, baby. You got to keep it busy, you understand me? Huh? You ain't putting your combinations together, David.
I'm going to be the...
You're bing, 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 that head and then back to that body both sides, you understand? Come
he's
on,
nailing
baby.
You when you're waiting, David. You're waiting to get off and he's hitting.
Let's take a look at that knockdown, which was resounding, and it appeared like it was the end of the fight. See the right hand? Perfect. It was a perfect punch. Delayed reaction. He goes down. Again, he didn't hang around to get that swarming Terry Norris killer punches. He just goes right down. It's a delayed reaction, and now he goes down. Let's look at it from another angle. Keep your eye on the right hand now. See, perfect right hand, placed just right. Terry going back to take advantage of it, but the guy's down.
So we move to the sixth. Two knockdowns in the fight, both by Norris, one in the first, one in the fifth. Gonzalez out there, refreshed from his corner.
Break!
Refresh being a relative term, I take it.
Yeah, I think he's standing, and that's a positive.
I don't think he's right. Yeah, I don't think he's ready for a day at the beach. What he's got here is a renewed chance to get more of a beating.
Watch the punch.
And Gonzalez still believing maybe he can get one punch in there and send Norris to the canvas.
Why not? It's been done. Hope springs eternal, and that's what makes fighting great. You just never know when one punch can change everything around.
Good uppercut by Norris.
And a stiff jab. That's the kind of jab that does danger.
Hunter, get out.
Does trouble.
Don't hold him. Right, step back.
It's a nuisance, too.
Yeah. And doesn't feel good on top of it.
There it is. He doubles up on that jab and sets up the right hand.
That's textbook fighting. One, two, repeat the jab, then the right hand. All he needs to do is put the left hook behind it. He hadn't done it his whole fight. I don't know why, because he certainly knows how to do that.
Gonzalez with the right to the body. But back to eating leather in the form of a right hand from Norris.
Well, he's just in trouble all over. If he gets on the ropes, he gets pummeled. If he gets outside in the middle of the ring, Terry outboxes him and bounces away from him.
He got up at the count of nine in that fifth round knockdown. Overhand right by Norris.
Yeah, if you just walked in right now from the street, you wouldn't think this guy had been down in such bad shape last round. He's chasing Terry around.
And Norris a little more limited in his movement when he's backed up against the ropes.
Yeah.
He's got nowhere to go.
A little bit of fox playing on the part of Terry Norris just then. He got it down low, missed all the punches, and came up with a nice little crisp uppercut.
Now he's back on his horse. Gonzalez lunging with that right to the body. Norris taking a little rest here.
Well, he's taking most of this round off. Whoa, look at that. That's the third time.
Once again, no knockdown. Just lunging and grabbing his opponent and riding him across the horse, across the ring like he was on Joe Sejanovic's ranch.
Yeah, it's just that there's no order to Gonzalez's attack. He doesn't know how to jab and come in. He's just kind of following around and hoping something's going to happen. There's no order to his fighting. There's no rhythm or rhyme to it. He's just punching.
Break!
Six rounds in the books.
And six rounds for Terry Norris.
The dressing room of David Kamau out of Kenya, now living in California, 26-0. The number one contender for the WBC super lightweight title. He's got a date later with Julio Cesar Chavez. Kamau has been talking up a big storm this week. We'll see if he backs up his words.
Now let's take a look at the hand speed, which is dominating Gonzalez. He just doesn't know what to do with it. See, they call it punches and bunches, and that's what that is right there. That's the illustration. Most of them landed, some didn't, but the thing is, it discombobulates Gonzalez. He has no game plan, no sense of fighting. Let's listen a moment.
Okay, don't stay in the rope.
Come
on out. That's what you tell a fighter that's winning. Nothing.
Well, his father's in the corner. About don't stay in the ropes. I thought that was a good point, right, Fer?
Yeah. His father's in the corner, Arlen, and his brother, Arlen Norris Jr., is around here someplace, ex-cruiserweight champion. Close family, very close family.
Norris basically took the sixth round off. Let's see if he comes out here with more of a vengeance in the seventh.
Yeah, that's terrible. That's just sloppy. You know. There's nothing you can do about it because the other guy's so tired.
This is for Norris's WBC super welterweight belt.
Hunter, get out!
First defense in his third reign as champion. There's the jab. Sharp. Doubled up there, maybe tripled up.
Oh.
And a right hand to boot.
Mm-hmm. That is what you call a jab, with finesse. Wow.
That jab has been accurate all night, right on the button.
Once again, wait, spin.
And again, some roughhouse tactics in the corner.
It's a good way to pop your shoulder up, by the way. Not a wonderful feeling when it pops up.
Norris goes to the body with the left hand.
But that jab is always there. Whenever Terry stops, out it comes. He bounces, he stops, pop, there goes the jab.
Gonzalez doing a lot of lunging.
Stop punching, stop punching.
He's trying to get that one shot in. It's so far been an impossibility.
But can you land an effective punch when you're lunging like that with no balance?
No, but then again, you know, we have seen Terry hurt by lunging punches. When he fought the Waters from Australia, he got hit you know, a lunging punch and almost went down. Right now, there's no evidence of the glass jaw. He's been hit a lot, and nothing's happened.
And that time, Norris showing that he listens to his corner a bit because he was close to the ropes and got away.
I must amend that. He didn't get hit a lot. He's been hit, and it didn't bother.
Break!
Richard Steele separating the fighters.
Come on, Ponte, get out of there.
45 Break. Seconds left for the seven. Norris goes through the ropes. And Steele will help him back in. That's the fourth time in the fight that he's either been pushed or hugged to the ground or through the ropes.
And he's lucky he's not fighting himself. If he was fighting Norris, Norris would have hit him going through the ropes. The old Norris hit you as you were going through the ropes.
So maybe Norris has learned some discipline.
Well, he's certainly fighting a disciplined fight here. He's not swarming over him. It looks like he can take him when he wants, but he wants the work, and he's getting it.
Another good left hand as Gonzalez came in.
Stronger, David. He's having to run now and get on his toes and try to revive himself, okay? Because he's wore out. He can't fight inside. You want your fight inside, man. You want your fight inside.
Get him started with some booming. I think fellas are going to a good shot. Help him out. Move, like you know.
Okay.
So you don't have to move so far. If you hit him, you don't have to move. Work yourself real hard.
Let's take a look at that little trip through the ropes that Terry Norris took because of the sloppy fight. See, he's being pushed. Physically pushed, and then once he gets to the ropes open, and he gets pushed some more. And of course, Gonzalez didn't stand there to give him a few shots, and it takes him a little time to come back up with the help of Richard Steele.
Remember, two losses by disqualification to Luis Santana, and Norris both times with illegal punches. And he has showed some good discipline in this fight, despite the fact that Gonzalez is trying to rough him up.
I haven't seen him punch to the back of the head once. I mean, not once. I mean, it's hard not to let a punch fly and miss him and hit back there.
Eighth round of the scheduled 12-rounder for the WBC Super Welterweight title.
Come on, punch again.
Norris red and white trunks. Gonzalez black trunks, gold trim. Nice combination by Norris, punctuated by the straight right.
Boy, that was a series of magnificent jabs. That was just beautiful.
Work inside and get out. Work and get out.
Norris switched to southpaw for a second there.
He can do anything. This guy, he goes one way, he goes the other. I don't think he needs to switch anything. All he needs to do is continue the attack straight forward with a jab, followed by the picture-perfect right hand, and it'll be all over.
Now he backs up Gonzalez again. Combination by Norris. Jab and straight right.
I had supper with his manager Joe Zanovich last night. Joe said, I'd be happy to get 6 or 7 good rounds out of this. He needs the rounds. Well, he's gone way past that. He's an 8.
Norris again falls down.
That's 4 times down and once through the rope.
Gonzalez goes to the body.
Don't wrestle.
And Richard Steele says, don't wrestle.
Nice overhand right hand that landed, but it affected the crowd more than it did Norris.
Gonzalez got hit pretty good as he came in there.
Break. Don't hold.
So Gonzalez doing everything he can to try to get Terry Norris maybe to commit a foul.
I think he's going to have a long night waiting for him to commit a foul. And I don't think that thought has vaguely crossed this guy's mind. Survival has crossed his mind a lot.
Three times in his career, though, Norris has had the illegal punches.
But, oh, look at that.
Now he's on target. Gonzalez's face starting to look battered.
And well it should from the amount of jabs alone that he's taken, much less the right hand.
A lot of swelling, a lot of puffiness around both the eyes of David Gonzalez. Norris landing that jab at will. And now a couple of uppercuts and a chopping left hook to the body.
Don't hold him, don't hold him.
Nice body shot by Norris.
Right on the belt.
Yeah. A little bit more and it would have been a low blow.
No holds.
Hey, Jim. That boy is knocked out on his feet, okay? He's already knocked out on his feet, okay? The only thing you have to do is just throw combinations. That's all. They don't have to be no powerful punches, just combination, and he's gonna go down. I can see his legs wobbling.
It's a man.
All right?
And you back him up, he can't play.
That's all.
And you stop him right in the center of the ring. And work him right in the center of the ring.
David, don't let him be getting off. You gotta get off, son. You gotta take the punch.
David, you wanna continue?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, he is. He can still win it, son.
Yeah, David, no, man. You gotta take it to him, David. Don't let him back you up, man. It's making you look really bad.
We're on this.
Just ask. By the doctor, you want to continue? All the corner said yes, but the referee, but the only guy didn't say it was a boxer. He just looked around.
But he had a couple of swabs in his mouth too.
Well, and he's getting all beat up.
Very gutty performance by David Gonzalez. He almost went down for the count in the fifth. He was 1 second away from being knocked out. Somehow got to his feet, and he's still here, and we're in the ninth.
He's not only still here, he's still fighting. I mean, give him credit, guts he's got. I mean, a lot of guts. He keeps coming, and he keeps coming after eating that jab. He still comes ahead. So, you know, it's one of those days where you get in there with a tough guy to knock out, and you've got to keep on fighting, whether you're the champion or not. You've got to keep on.
Time to get out.
This is a tough business, Bucks.
And Norris, on the other hand, has to just try not to get real frustrated because this guy's still standing here.
Well, it's what they told him in the corner. The guy's legs are wobbling. You don't need any big shot. You just need combinations. Just complete bang, bang, bang combinations. You'll knock him out. I happen to agree with that.
Swift body blow by Norris as he dug that left hand in. Another one, and he follows it with an uppercut.
Now, if he'd have followed that with a right hand, he'd have been in business. You see, combinations are like, there's so many of them coming that you don't know where they're coming from, and you start receiving them all.
Gonzalez is still getting through. He's thrown a couple of right hands that landed to the face of Terry Norris.
They just don't have much power, you know what I mean?
Right. Get off
the beating
get
off he's taking, oh, he's down again. What's that, six?
Six times.
It's getting to be a marathon.
Doubling and tripling up on the jab is Norris.
Oh, look at that jab. His head went right back with it. That's what you call a beautiful jab. For all you people that are students of boxing, this is the key to the championship of boxing. A jab. A jab is the key to get into heaven there.
Punch again.
And more than one gets you to heaven quicker, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And if you got a right hand and a left hook to follow, you get there just automatically. Oh,
nice combination by Norris.
Oh.
Right hand to the head. Gonzalez backs up and somehow stays up again. Now the left gets through, then the right. Blood is flying everywhere now.
Boy, it is one-sided now. That's a one-sided beating now. Steele looking real hard at him.
Norris pummeling him.
Steele is looking very hard at Gonzalez now because this is getting to be senseless.
Norris throwing hooks with on, both hands. A bloody nose.
And an indifferent right hand.
How much longer will Gonzalez handle the punishment?
How much longer will his corner let him? How much longer will Steele let him?
This one's close to being stopped. Steele's right in there. Coming up on 10 seconds in the ninth round. Right hand by Norris.
Steele's right there.
This one is almost over. Steele steps in, it's over. Before the bell, it's over. Richard Steele stopped him with a second left in the ninth round. And a TKO victory for Terry Norris and a good stoppage by the ref there.
Absolutely good. Once again, Steele's gonna get into a little bit of trouble because he stopped it just at the bell. So all the fans and his corner is going to do this de rigueur, complaining that the round was almost over. But that was merciful and correct on the part of Richard Steele. That was a one-way beating and no reason whatsoever to let it continue.
Terry Norris stops David Gonzalez at the end of the ninth round. Richard Steele stepping in. and saying that Gonzalez had really taken enough punishment at that point.
Well, I think he had. I mean, in the interest of safety and the health of Gonzalez, who has put up a gutty performance. Let's not denigrate his performance. It was a good performance by a guy that was just outclassed by a superb Terry Norris. Terry Norris back in form, completely in control of himself. No question about it. I think he's returned to his form. From here on out, we can look for a series of Terry Norris fights the way we used to, instead of looking for those chaotic events.
This is the kind of performance against the likes of Mugabe and Leonard, Meldrick Taylor and Maurice Blocker, Fernie, pretty big names for the past.
Oh yeah. Well, let's take a look at this incredible series of punches, which got Gonzalez in too much trouble. Look at that. To the side, to both sides, like indiscriminate, one side, the other, and then to the head. Uppercut, right, overhand right. Another jab coming in there. Terry Norris now senses it, feels like all he's got to do is set him up, and this is the end of the fight, when it was apparent to everyone except the most rabid fan that it was all over. Blood all over the face of Gonzalez. Gonzalez with no clue where he is or what he's doing. The only thing that he is perpendicular to the earth at that moment. He's out on his feet.
Win number 40 for Terry Norris, and this is first title defense of his third reign as champion. He knocked down David Gonzalez in the first and in the fifth early on, and it looked as though Gonzalez was going to go. He was down at the count of nine, somehow got to his feet, continued, lasted through the fifth, and then took a punishment in the sixth, seventh, eighth, and in the ninth round. So Norris retains the title. And right now, let's go up to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a time of 2 minutes 59 seconds in round number 9. A referee in charge, Richard Steele, says Gonzalez has had enough, stops the contest, the winner by way of technical knockout, and still champion, terrible, Terry Norris.
Terrible Terry Norris at 2:59, the official time, with the TKO over David Gonzalez. Norris, a lot longer action tonight. If you think about his last three fights against Santana, this was the equivalent of those three. He went nine rounds tonight, so he wanted to get a workout of six or more. He got plenty of it. He is now 14-4 in championship fights. Pretty good mark for Mr. Norris. And still to come, our main event of the night, as Julio Cesar Chavez defends his WBC super lightweight title against unheralded and undefeated David Kamau. That's still ahead, but right now let's go back inside the ring to Ferdy Pacheco.
Well, you're back, Terry. No question about it. Are you satisfied with that performance?
Tonight, yeah, I am. You know, I underestimated him a little bit. I didn't think he would come out as hard and put a lot of pressure. I didn't think we'd have the win to keep it up. You know, I put it on him early, dropped him in the first round, but he sucked it up and came back out. So I had to take my hat off to him. He fought a hell of a fight.
You know, you seemed to be like your old self, patient. You were waiting. You had a jab going. You didn't go crazy. You didn't go after him. Did you do that intentionally? Because you look like you're the old Terry Norris. Let's say it that
definitely.
Way.
Definitely. I wanted to just pace him, you know, watch him and catch him with good shots. I didn't want to go back to that Santana thing. Hit him with some good shots and catch him on the way down. I didn't want to do that. So, you know, I paced myself. We worked in the gym for that hours. You know?
All right. We're going to look at a replay of the first and the last knockdown. And I want you to comment as you saw it. The first, and this is the first round. You take it over.
Well, you know, I'm just basically just setting him up with a jab. Boom. And then catching him with good combinations. It's going to be a jab right hand. I believe it's going to drop him. There he goes. Boom. There it is right there. Jab right hand. That's my strongest punch. I guess I knocked everybody out.
Did you think he was going to get? Here's round five. Let's go with that.
I didn't think he was going to get up, but he did. He came back fighting hard, and here he is still in the fifth round, and I'm just landing all kinds of shots on him, just trying to get him out of there. He's a strong guy, you know. I respect him. Take my hat off to him.
That was a right hand both times, and you were landing it all night. But the thing that impressed me the most was your jab. It just seemed like you were a master of the jab that day.
That's something we worked on in the gym, you know. Use that jab, blind him with the jab, catch him with a good right hand, catch him with a good hook. And I'm going to keep trying to use that jab, keep boxing, and keep doing what I did.
It It's really odd when you stop to think about it. You retained your championship and you went down five times. I mean, right. So I suppose you look at the papers that Terry Norris is down five times, but he won the title. What does that feel like going down like that?
Oh, really? It's kind of, you know, it's a bad take, you know, because it knocked me out of the pound for pound ratings. I believe I'm still one of the pound for pound best fighters in the world, but losing to Santana the way that I did, they kind of just took me out of that. So it hurt me a little bit, but I'm back. I'm gonna get back up in the top 10.
All right, coming in is the much reviled, but unjustly so, Richard Steele. We're movie stars together. Richard, tell me something. You think that fight was stopped right at the belt, was correctly stopped? I did.
Correct, Freddie. I felt that the fight should have been stopped. It doesn't make any difference how much time in that round. He still had three or four more rounds to go, and I knew he could not make four rounds.
That was a wise choice, and I don't think anybody can boo you for that one. That was okay.